Well, nestled in the hills of Northwest Washington is a little piece of history and culture.
That's right, at the Hillwood Estate, you can explore beautiful gardens and nearly 17,000 pieces of artwork. And Eileen Whalen is live from Northwest to give us a tour of those beautiful gardens. Eileen?
Oh my gosh, guys, this really is quite an oasis. I have to say, with today's weather, it feels a little bit like a rainforest, but that's okay because it is absolutely breathtaking. And head gardener Jessica Bonilla is here with us to tell us a little bit more. So first of all, just inform the public about Hillwood and what it's all about.
All right. Well, Hillwood is the former estate of Marjorie Meriwether Post. She'd had a great collection of French and Russian decorative arts. So she bought Hillwood in the 1950s to showcase that her collection. And so we sit on 25 acres, and about half of that is manicured, and here we are in the lunar lawn in front of our seasonal planting.
Yeah, well, you guys do so much here. I mean, as far as, you know, keeping the museum, the estate, and the gardens looking, you know, so fabulous. So here we are in the lunar lawn. Tell us about some of the flowers, because these are all seasonal.
Yes, yeah, we do three change outs a year. We do, start with tulips and bulbs in the spring, and then our summer flowers and tropicals, and then our mums for the fall. But here we have Cleome, and we have a border of the begonias that is called Big Bronze Rose.
They're so vibrant. It was one of the first things that I noticed when I came out here, because just they're such a vibrant and pretty pink.
Yes, absolutely. And that's really balanced with the dark red coleus behind there that is a cultivar called Redhead. And then we made a kind of a green border in the back with the different colocasias in there in the background as well.
And I have to say, I asked you earlier, these are my favorite. I've never seen them before. What are these ones that we're looking at?
Yeah, that's the Cleome. It's also known as a spider flower. And you see it, how it has the seed pods kind of look like the legs of the spider.
So you guys will change them out in the fall around September. And I mean, being the head gardener, how much do you get to choose in the design?
Well, it's really a collaborative effort. I work with Jason Gedyke. He's the head of design operations, and also with Drew Asbury. He's the head gardener. We really work together and take input of the other gardeners and come up with different designs. But we're really planning about 9 months out for each season. So it's
a lot of hard work. And quickly, for the people at home that, you know, are trying to maintain their gardens, you know, what is some advice that you have for them to really flourish?
Well, this year has been a very interesting year with all the rain that we've had. So fortunately, not too much watering. Sometimes you may need to do a little extra fertilizer. There's a lot of great organic products out there that really can keep your plants flourishing and get you through the season until the fall.
Wonderful. Some great advice. Excellent work. Thank you for all that you do. Hillwood Estate Museum and Garden is open to the public, so come get a little bit of history and enjoy all of the hard work that you have put in to make this garden so beautiful. We're going to be joining Jessica again, and what are we talking about in our next garden?
We're going to talk about some containers and how you take care of your containers at this time of the year.
All right, wonderful. Well, we will see you coming up in our next hour. For now, though, back inside to you guys.